Hello and welcome back everyone. So in the last video we covered the order controllers and the order service, product controller and product service. Now as we have all these modules, we can just add them like the product module. So we have imported them. We can just add these modules to the main modules. So now these are the parts of our application and we should be able to see all the routes created. Like we can see here, all the routes are now registered, order and product with login and register, right? All the routes are now published. So before we finish up all this series, what we are going to do, we are going to look at the most common aspects, like we were using some interceptors and filters. So how we can use these interceptors globally, locally, or at a controller level. So first you will take a look on exception filters. So how we can use these exception filters at the controller level, like I wanted to use it at the controller level. So I will just use it, use filter. And in the use filter, I can just provide the filter name. New HTTP exception filter. Okay, I have to write HTTP. New HTTP exception filter. This is how you can register a filter to a controller. Okay, this is the one way. Other way is, okay, I don't want it to use it at the controller level. I wanted to use it as a global level. So in that case, what you can do is in the main.ts, you can do is app.use global filter. So here we can see interceptors and filters, and you can add new HTTP exception. It's not coming up. Let's see this new HTTP. Sorry, we can just import it. So this is how we can use it globally. This is another way, right? Or at a module level, how we can inject it. So in the shared module, what we can do is we can get this app filter and app interceptors. So this is from the documentation, exception filters, the many ways of importing it. So one way is, so in the providers, you can override the definition of app filters and app interceptors with your custom class. So what we can do is in the shared module, we can provide. So what we are going to do is provide app filter. And what is the filter class? Use class. The class name is HTTP exception filter. Okay, this is another way. Here you have provided this in the shared module, and we are using shared module in every other module, so you don't need to set it globally. We can get rid of this. This is the one way. So this is how you can set a particular filter. Okay, same way, let's go with the interceptors. So let's go to the product controller. Here I wanted to set an interceptor. I think we were using, earlier we were using one controller, so we will use the same one. Product controller. Okay, let's use this. So here we wanted to use an interceptor. Use interceptors and you can pass. So we are going to use a new logging interceptor. This is how you can add an interceptor at controller level. You can add it to any controller, and this is actually logging interceptor we have added. This interceptor, okay, let me import all the things which are required to make this working. Use interceptor. You can set this globally also in your main module, in your main.ts. So what we need to do is app.set app.global interceptors, and you can pass new logging interceptor. So you can set global filter, you can set global interceptor, you can set interceptors and filters at the controller level, you can set the interceptors and filters at the module level. So here, like shared module, other properties we can use is provide. I'm going to override app interceptor. Okay, and use class. Class can be logging interceptor. right? So using this, I'm overriding the definition here. In this case, you don't need this global definition. I was just using it for just an example to show how it works. Okay, you don't need it. These at the controller level. And here is my controller, other controller. Now, if you try to hit this particular request, I think this is getting boot up. Let's see if we don't see any error and our server is good to go. We can save all the files. Okay, now when you try to hit the basic APIs, we are getting this method, message, timestamp and code. How that is happening? That is happening because we are using this HTTP exception filter, which is adding all these other required attribute, timestamp, path, method, message in the response. So we are getting enough big response, which is having the status code, message, error code, request, timestamp, path, for which particular URL this particular error has encountered. And other thing is, we are using the logger in the shared module. Now I have added this logger. So we are overriding two things, app filter and app interceptors, and we are overriding these with these classes. So this should be applied on all the modules. So here you see the product module, we are injecting it, shared module. Similarly, the order module, we are using shared module. Okay, now all these routes are coming up. So like if you see this 404, right? 404 is coming because we have already added this. HTTP interceptor is working. That's why we are able to see all the things happening. And in the app module, we are using shared module. And in the shared module, we have app filter, exception filter and logging interceptor. Logging interceptor should be able to intercept your request which are coming and going. So I mean, I'd like to intercept the it globally. So what you can set is app.set set global, you can see global interceptor. Okay, so it will take care of the logging. You can set it anyway using controllers or using at a module level or at the application level. So once we register it like this, once the request is come, we will be able to see the nice logs coming. Or you can also use a Nest.js passport module to set up a different kind of a logging. You can use a logger module. In the logger module, you can define all the different log levels and you boot that application from the log level defined in the ENV. Okay, so similarly, Swagger module, you can have a Redis module, Logger module, database module, all these modules. Okay, and finally, the product service, the end-to-end application, we will see that working in the last video. Now, if you just try to hit this. I'm not sure why the logs are not coming. I just set this interceptor globally. Something wrong. Maybe I have override that somewhere. Logging interceptor. I'm not using it here. Okay, that we can take a look later. But this is how you can intercept, and you can actually define your interceptors and your filters and your pipes. Here we are using, in this application, we are using a lot of concepts. We are using the guards, right? Like seller guard, we are using interceptor, we are using filters, we are using controllers, services, lot of things. I mean, each and every concept of Nest.js is covered. We are writing the DTOs to do the data validations using the classes in different components. Here you can just convert it to a class and you can define the API properties. So API with the help of API properties, this particular value will be available in the Swagger doc. I mean, you don't need to create interface for DTOs. The classes should always be good. API property. Okay. Similarly, we can do for order DTO. I think this is already done. Okay, thanks everyone. We'll just look at the last video and we are done with this Nest.js with MongoDB. But we will cover a full-blown project with the Nest.js and MySQL. where we will show one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-many relationships.